Sri Gurudev Namaha. Today we are going to discuss quadratic equation, chapter number 4, quadratic equation. In that I have completed 4.1 and 4.2 exercise, right? 4.1, we represent the word problem in terms of quadratic equation alone. In 4.2, I discussed that how to factorize. Three methods are there. First method is sum product method, that I taught you. Today I am going to teach using quadratic formula how to solve the quadratic equation. The quadratic formula will decide the nature of the root. The another name of quadratic formula is Sridhar Acharya formula. Right? Quadratic formula, I said. Quadratic formula or Sridhar Acharya formula. Because the mathematician Sridhar Acharya, he derived so that the name was given for that formula, right? Now, how to use the quadratic formula? What does it mean? That you have to understand first, right? D is equal to, capital D is equal to B square minus 4AC. What is capital D? The capital D is discriminant. D-I-S-C-R-I-M-I, discriminant. N-A-N-T, right? Discriminant. D is equal to B square minus 4AC. D should be represented as discriminant, right? Then what is the standard form of quadratic formula? What is the standard form of quadratic equation? AX square plus BX plus C equal to 0. What is the standard form of quadratic equation? Already I discussed, then again I recall you. AX square plus BX plus C. Here I said the discriminant, B square minus 4AC. Right. B is represented coefficient of X. A is represented coefficient of X square. C is represented constant. Right. Now, three things are there. Using the discriminant, we are going to say the nature of the root. Right. D greater than 0 means the roots are real and distinct. Unequal, that is nothing but different, right? D greater than 0, that is discriminant. The B square minus 4AC, the combination is represented by D. That D is the full form of D is discriminant, right? D greater than 0, the roots are real and distinct or unequal, or you can say it is different, right? Next, D equal to 0, that is discriminant equal to 0. Discriminant is nothing but B square minus 4AC, right? Now, the roots are real and equal, right? D greater than 0, the roots are real and distinct or unequal or different. D equal to 0, the roots are real and equal. Equal in the sense same. Right. D less than 0. D less than 0, the roots are imaginary. The roots are imaginary. We can't find the roots. Right. Imaginary. Or you can say no real roots. Or you can say no real roots. Again, I'll explain today what I said. Today I'm going to teach the quadratic formula. Using quadratic formula, you can say the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. The quadratic formula, another name is Sridharacharya formula. You people never used to forget because our correspondent name is there, right? Now, D is equal to B square minus 4AC. D is represented as the full form of D is discriminant. The full form of D is discriminant. What is the standard form of quadratic equation? Standard form of quadratic equation is, already you know, again I repeat, right? Ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Here b is represented coefficient of x, a is represented coefficient of x square, c is represented constant. I said nature of the root. Three things we are going to discuss. D greater than 0, the roots are real and distinct, or unequal or different. Next, D is equal to 0, the roots are real and equal. Equal in the sense, same. D less than 0, the symbol you have to be very careful, children, right? Greater than means the mouth should be open towards left. Less than means the mouth should be open towards right. D less than 0, the roots are imaginary, or you can say no real roots. Yeah, now we have exercise 2.4. Find the nature of roots of the following equations. Nature of roots of the following equation. If the real roots exist, that means if the real root exists in the sense D may be greater than 0 or D equal to 0, means you can proceed, otherwise you stop, right? Nature of the roots. Three things I said, isn't it? D greater than 0, the roots are real and distinct. Real and distinct. D equal to 0, the roots are real and equal. Real and equal. One more word I said. What I said? The same, or you can say coincident, right? Equal, instead of equal you say same, or coincident, or coincident, right? Equal or same or coincident. Next, D less than 0, the roots are imaginary. Imaginary sense, we can't find it, right? Imaginary. Or no real roots. Whenever the question you see the nature of the roots, immediately these three things should come to your mind, right? D means what? D is equal to B square minus 4AC. D equal to what I said? B square minus 4AC. What is that? What name for this I say? You can say quadratic formula or Sridhar Acharya formula, right? Quadratic formula or Sridhar Acharya formula. Now, what is B? What is B, I said? B is nothing but coefficient of x. B is nothing but coefficient of x. A, coefficient of x square. C, constant. You should write along with the symbol. Keep one thing in your mind. Listen carefully. What I said, B, coefficient of x. A, coefficient of x square. C, constant. Now I am going to write what is B, what is A and what is C. See here, what is your B? B equal to minus 3, right? B equal to minus 3. What is your A? A, very good. A equal to 2. A equal to 2. What is your C? C equal to 5, right? Coefficient of x is your B. Coefficient of x square is A. Constant is your C. Then you go and substitute in the formula, right? B is equal to B square. Here you one thing you have to listen. B alone I put the symbol negative. A and C, if you didn't put the symbol, that you consider as positive. That you know, right? So, minus 3 the whole square minus 4 into, what is your A? 2. What is your C? 5. Right? Which is equal to 9 minus 4 twos are 8. 8 into 5, 40. What you arrive here, you see 9 minus 40. Positive, negative, do the subtraction and put the greater number symbol. Whenever you do the calculation, you have to be very careful, right? So what you get? Minus 30, minus 31. Negative number is always less than 0, that you know, right? Negative number is always less than 0. What you conclude at the end? D less than 0. When you arrive D less than 0, what is the nature of the root for this equation? D less than 0, the roots are imaginary, or you can say no real roots, right? So what is your conclusion at the end, or what is the answer for this question? Is the nature of the root, that is the roots are imaginary. Therefore, the roots are imaginary. Right? The roots are imaginary. Again, I recall the condition that alone you have to keep it in your mind. Whenever you see nature of the roots, immediately these three conditions should come to your mind. Then B is equal to B square minus 4AC. Sometimes they may ask, use Sridhar Acharya formula, find the nature of the root. Immediately what it will come to your mind? Quadratic formula, then D is equal to B square minus 4AC. That is the condition you have to use and find the nature of the roots. Okay. Next subdivision, right? Next subdivision is what? 3x square minus 4 3x plus 4 equal to 0. Here also we are going to use the same format, right? We want to find the nature of the roots, right? D is equal to B square minus 4AC. Each and every sum you people have the habit to write the formula, right? Then only you people will not commit mistake. D is equal to, what is B I told you? Minus 4 root 3. What is A? A equal to 3. What is C? C is equal to 4. Very good, right? Now we want to apply in the formula, that is discriminant, right? Discriminant is denoted by capital D. What is the full form of capital D? Discriminant, right? D is equal to B square minus 4AC. What are the things we need that you have to gather first? After that you are going to substitute, right? D is equal to B square minus 4 root 3 the whole square minus 4 root 3 the whole square minus 4 into what is your A? 3. What is your C? 4. Right? 4 into 3 into 4. If I use the bracket, that it represents multiplication, right? Now, minus the whole square, so it becomes positive. 4 square means that is 16. Root 3 the whole square. Root 3 the whole square is nothing but 3. Root 3 the whole square is nothing but 3. How I said root 3 the whole square is 3? See here. Root 3 into root 3. That is the meaning, right? Root 3 the whole square is nothing but root 3 into root 3. One thing you have to listen. How to express this? 3 power 1 by 2 into 3 power 1 by 2. Am I right? Now, which is equal to, if the base is same, here you are applying law of exponent. A power m into a power n equal to a power m plus n, right? A power m into a power n equal to a power m plus n. The formula is applicable if the base is same, right? Now you see, a power m into a power n equal to, so what do you get? 3 power 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2, half plus half, 1. So you arrive at the result as 3. That's why I said root 3 the whole square is nothing but 3. Now I am going to write. Right? Already these things you know. D greater than 0, the roots are real and discrete. D equal to 0, the roots are real and equal. D less than 0, the roots are imaginary or no real roots. Here you see D is equal to minus 4 root 3. I told you minus become positive. 4 becomes 16. 3 root 3 become 3. So what do you get? 16 into 3. 16 into 3. Here also the same. 4 3s are 12. Or you can write 4 4s are 16. 16 into 3. What it comes to your mind? 16 into 3. The same number. Here also 16 into 3. Same. You will get it as 0. Or you can multiply and say 16 3s are 48. Minus 48 equal to what you are at? 0. D equal to 0 means what I said? The roots are real and equal. The roots are real and equal. Therefore, the roots are, these are the things if you want, you should write it in the right side. Right? The roots are real and equal. See, the first question, you said the roots are imaginary, so no issue. But in the question, you have to read again. Whenever the question is given, you have to read twice, understand what are the things they ask, that whether we complete or not, you have to check. Then only you should end up your sum, right? Nature of the root, we got it. One more thing, what they said, if the real roots exist, if the real root exists, here they said the roots are real and equal, that is the sense, the roots exist, that means you should find out, if D equal to 0, how to find the roots, if D equal to 0 means, X is equal to minus B by 2A, comma minus B by 2A. Friend, what I wrote? X is equal to the roots. If D equal to 0 means for finding the roots, you should use this. Right? For finding the roots, you have to use this. What I wrote here, you see, minus B by 2A, minus B by 2A. Why I wrote same? What it is there? The roots are real and equal. That means same or coincident. Right? That's why I wrote x is equal to minus b by 2a, comma minus b by 2a. The same number you have to write twice. That is the meaning. Right? Now, x is equal to, what is your b? Minus 4 root 3. Already minus is there. So, minus into minus plus. So, what do you get? 4 root 3. Did you understand what I am telling? B is minus 4 root 3. Formula minus, so minus into minus plus 4 root 3 divided by 2 into. What is your A? 3. What is your A? 3. Comma. Again, minus into minus plus 4 root 3 divided by 2 into 3. Next, x is equal to 4 root 3 by 2 into 3. Listen, you know the cancellation, right? You have to cancel. 2 2's are. Right? Here also the same. 2 2's are. Here one thing you listen. Here root 3 is there, here 3 is there. I gave an idea. Root 3 can be written as root 3 into root 3. 3 can be written as root 3 into root 3. That you have to use it here. You are going to make a solution in the simplest. Right? X is equal to 2 root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3. Comma 2 root 3 divided by root 3 into root 3. 2 3 root 3 cancel. Root 3 root 3 cancel. So what is your answer at the end? X is equal to the solution you have to highlight, right? Solution or the roots, right? Solution or you can write the roots are better you write. The roots are x is equal to 2 by root 3, comma 2 by root 3. Right? The first question you have no issue. The roots are imaginary. But here what you have? D equal to 0. If D equal to 0 means what is the condition? The roots are real and equal. Equal is nothing but same. Or coincident you can say. Now, a power m into a power n equal to a power m plus n. What you learn that you have to recall, right? Why I recall that root 3 is there? How I arrived at 3? For that purpose, I gave the explanation here, right? Now, therefore, the roots are real and equal. If the roots are real and equal, the question is, if the real roots exist, you should find out. So, x is equal to minus b by 2a minus b by 2a. Two times you have to write because it is a quadratic equation. You want two roots. X is equal to minus into minus plus. So, 2 root 3 divided by 2 into 3. Here also 4 root 3 divided by 2 into 3. Cancellation is possible. You have to cancel the 3. You know very well it can be written as root 3 into root 3. So the 3 I modified here as root 3 into root 3. Root 3, root 3 cancel. Finally, we arrive. X is equal to 2 by root 3, comma 2 by root 3. I hope you people understand. I will pass on to the next question. The third subdivision, right? 2x square minus 6x plus 3 equal to 0. Here also, first what you want to find? Nature of the root, right? Nature of the root means what we need? D equal to b square minus 4ac. From the given equation, what are the things you want to write? A, B, C, right? Now, what is A? A equal to 2. What is B? Right. B equal to minus 6. B equal to minus 6. What is C? C is equal to 3. Right. D equal to B square minus 4AC. You have to say repeatedly. Then only it should be registered in your mind. Then D is equal to, D is nothing but discriminant. D is nothing but discriminant. D is equal to B square minus 6 square. Minus 6 square. Minus 4 into 2 into 3. Minus, that is B square. Minus 4AC. Your A is 2. Your C is 3. Your B is minus 6. I told you, whenever you write what is A, B, C, you should write along with the symbol. If it is positive, you have no issue. But if it is negative, you write the negative symbol. That is important. Right? Now, this is equal to 6, 6 or 36. The negative will become positive. So, 36 minus 4 2's are 8. 8 3's are 24. Which is equal to 36 minus 24. Positive, negative. Do the subtraction and put the greater number symbol. 36 minus 24. 12. See, negative number means it is less than 0. Positive number means it is greater than 0. Positive number means it is greater than 0. Greater than 0 means what I said? The roots are real and distinct. Distinct in the sense what? Unequal, different, right? Now, the nature you are going to say it as, the roots are real and distinct. Okay, you said the roots are real and distinct. That is the sense the roots exist. That is the same, the roots exist. In that question, what they ask, if the real root exists, you should find out. D is less than 0. When you arrive D is negative, you have no issue. Suppose if you arrive D equal to 0 or D greater than 0, you want to find the roots. D equal to 0 means what I said, x is equal to minus b by 2a. X is equal to minus b by 2a minus b by 2a. Because it is a quadratic equation, it has two roots. It has at most two roots, right? Now, d greater than 0. D greater than 0 means how can you find the roots? That also I am going to teach. X is equal to minus b plus or minus. How to pronounce this? Plus r minus root 3 divided by 2a. Right? Minus b plus or minus root d divided by 2a. When you attain d equal to 0, you will get in this part alone. Right? When you attain d equal to 0, what can you get? Minus b by 2a. If d greater than 0, d greater than 0 means, what is your, how to find the roots? D greater than 0 means how to find the roots? X is equal to minus b plus or minus root d divided by 2a. Everything you have, right? D equal to minus 6, you know. D is equal to 12 also you got. A is also there. Directly you are going to substitute, right? X is equal to, what is your b? B is minus 6. Already minus is there. So minus into minus plus 6. You have to be very careful. Your b is minus 6. According to the formula, it has minus. So minus into minus plus 6 plus or minus plus or minus. What is your d? You arrive 12. Root 12 divided by 2 into 2. 2 into 2. Your b is minus 6. Already minus, so minus into minus plus. Right? I hope you people understand, right? Then plus or minus, what is your d? D equal to 12. Root 12 divided by 2 into 2. Right? Here, using this 2 and 6, you cannot cancel because it is a combination. Right? Combination, whenever comes, you cannot cancel a single term alone. I will teach you how to cancel the term. 6 plus or minus 12. You know, you should write the 12 in terms of one number should be a perfect number, another number should be a prime number. Like that you will get, right? 12 means what are the possibilities? 6, 2 are 4, 3 are, right? Because the square root is there, I selected the possibility as 4 into 3 divided by 2 into 2, 4, right? X is equal to, listen, the root 12, you have the possibility 1 into 12, 6 into 2, 4 into 3. Here square root is there, so that I select the possibility as 4 into 3. Why I selected the possibility? I can apply the square root for 4 because it is a perfect square, right? Now, x is equal to 6 plus or minus, in between multiplication, I can apply the square root for 4 separately as well as 3 separately. When I apply square root for 4, what I can get? 2. The square root of 3 is as such. I cannot modify, right? 2 into 2, 4. Now I can cancel because here 2 is there, 2 into 3. Here 2 is there, 2 into root 3. I can take 2 as common. X is equal to 2 into, in the combination, if any number is common, you can take it as outside, right? So what is the rest here? When I took 2 as common, right? If I took 2 from this term, means what is there? Root 3 divided by. So now I can cancel because in between multiplication is there. So what is the final answer? X is equal to 3 plus or minus root 3 divided by 2. You may ask the question, this you said the roots are real and distinct. I want to tell you how the roots are real and distinct, right? X is equal to the roots are x is equal to 3. First you should connect this number to the positive. Next you should connect the number to the negative. Then you can get the roots or realize this thing. X is equal to 3 plus root 3 by 2 comma 3 minus root 3 by 2. Now we people understand everything, right? The roots are real and distinct. Here also you are getting two different roots. Whenever d greater than 0, what formula you have to apply for finding the root? X is equal to minus b plus or minus root d divided by 2a. Here 12, the possibility is 1 into 12, 6 into 2, 4 into 3. Why I selected 4? I gave the reason, isn't it? 4 means I can apply the square root. The 4, it will act as 2 for that purpose. So 6 plus or minus 2 root 3 divided by 4. Here I can take 2 as common. 2 into 3. So when I took 2 as common, plus 6 it comes under 3. Plus or minus, here 2 I took it as common. So only root 3 divided by 4. Now I can cancel. Here I cannot cancel the single term. Why I say? Because it is a combination. Whenever combination comes, you cannot cancel the single term. You keep it in your mind. You people normally used to commit mistake in that area, right? Now, x is equal to 3 plus or minus 2, 3 by 2, right? You may ask the question, right? Roots are real and distinct, you say. That real and distinct I showed you. X is equal to 3 plus or minus root, sorry, plus 2, 3 by 2, 3 minus 2, 3 by 2. This is the formula when D greater than 0. This is the formula when D greater than 0. Minus B plus or minus root D divided by 2A. When you can say D greater than 0? If the number is positive. Right?